हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट पॉलिनोमियल एंड आई विल सॉल्व अ प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन पॉलिनोमियल। हियर यू कैन सी आई हैव रिटन पी एक्स इज इक्वल टू ए एन एक्स टू द पावर एन ए एन माइनस एक्स टू द पावर एन माइनस वन प्लस dot 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 and a1x plus a0. In fact, it is the pattern of a polynomial which have a highest degree n. So, this is a polynomial which is called polynomial of degree n, where n is an integer and these are the coefficient an, an minus 1, a1. These are the coefficient of variable x and these are in fact real number. So, this is the ideal pattern of polynomial. But in common language, I will explain polynomial. For example, if I am writing ax square px is equal to px is equal to a sorry 2x square plus 3x plus 4, what you can see here there is a highest degree of x is 2 and the coefficient of x square is 2, coefficient of x is 3, and this is a constant term. So, because the highest degree is 2, so it is called quadratic polynomial. There are many kinds of polynomial. Number one, for example, number one, constant polynomial. What do you mean by constant polynomial? A polynomial of degree 0 is called constant polynomial. Okay? A polynomial of degree 0 is called constant polynomial. For example, 5. Only 5 is also a polynomial itself, but the degree of polynomial is 0. So, this is called constant polynomial. Next type of polynomial is linear polynomial. Linear polynomial means in short, I will say, if degree of polynomial is 1, then it is called linear polynomial. Okay? For example, 2x plus 3, here what is the power of x? You can easily see power of x is 1. So, it is a linear polynomial. Other type of polynomials are, third type is quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. Okay? The degree of quadratic polynomial is 2. It means there is a power, highest power on x is 2. Okay? So, for example, 2x square plus 3x plus 7. This is the quadratic polynomial because highest degree power of x is 2. So this is a quadratic polynomial. In this way, there are many kind of polynomial and they all are based on the highest power because a cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial we can express it as px is equal to ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, or if with the numerical value we can take any value 2x cube plus 3x square plus 4x plus 7. This is called cubic polynomial because the highest power of x is 3. This is called cubic polynomial. Okay, so I hope you have understand these things, and now I will explain some important thing about quadratic polynomial. Okay, so first of all, we will write a quadratic polynomial pattern ax square plus bx plus c. So we will find its roots and verify it with the coefficient. There is a numerical on your book. So first of all, if you know this is a quadratic polynomial because the highest power is x, so how many roots of this polynomial? So always remember, the number highest power, always degree of polynomial tell us that how many roots possible for a particular polynomial. For example, if there is a linear polynomial, then there will be only one root of that polynomial. If there is a quadratic polynomial, then here degree is 2, so only 2 roots are possible. If you have cubic polynomial, then only 3 roots are possible because highest degree is 3 or degree of polynomial is 3. Okay, so let alpha and beta are the roots of given polynomial. Then we will write the relationship between sum of this root and coefficient of these polynomials. Okay, for example, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. This is a verification formula, you can say, and other alpha into beta is equal to c by a. This is called sum of roots, and this is called product of roots. So we can use these formula, verification formula, and find the relationship between sum of roots and coefficient of given polynomial. So I'm going to write a polynomial, quadratic polynomial, and I will verify it with this given formula. So for example, there is a question. I'm just writing a question. What is the question or sum? Find the zeros of quadratic polynomial fx is equal to x square plus 8x plus 15, and verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficient, zeros and the coefficients. Okay, so now we will see how we can solve this. First of all, write fx is equal to x square plus 8x plus 15. This is the given polynomial, so first find the root of this polynomial or zeros of this polynomial by middle term split. I know you people are aware about the middle term split because it is in the syllabus of 8th, 9th even, 8th, 9th class. So, x square and here we can break 5x plus 3x plus 15 and x is common, x plus 5 and here we will take 3 as a common, x plus 5 and f plus 3 and x plus 5. For the zeros, fx is equal to 0, so x plus 3, x plus 5 is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to minus 3, x is equal to minus 5. These two values are the 0 of this quadratic polynomial. Now we will verify with this given formula. So what is the sum of roots? So we can write it alpha, we can take it as alpha and we can take it as beta. Now use the formula, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Take the alpha, minus 3 plus minus 5 is equal to minus, what is the value of b? This is the b, here a, this is the b. So write down 8 by, and what is the value of a? 1. So what you will get, this is minus 8 and this is minus 8. So it is equal, so verify. Now use product formula. So what is the product? A alpha into beta is equal to c by a. Take it, alpha and beta, minus 3 into minus 5 is equal to, what is the c? C is the 15 and by a. So we will get plus 15 is equal to plus 15. So here what we see? Here product or sum of alpha is equal to the ratio minus b by a, and the product of alpha and beta is also equal to the value of coefficient. We can say that hence verify. So this is the method through which we can verify the relationship between the zeros and coefficient of given quadratic equation with the help of this formula. So I hope you understand this method. Thank you. Thank you very much for watching.